Welcome to Michigan Out of Doors. I'm Jenny Olson, and this week's show is jam-packed full of hunting excitement. We'll take you to the northern Lower Peninsula, where I got to spend some time in a bear camp in the Cadillac area. Lots of fun stuff happening there. And Jimmy spent some time in the woods with his daughter.
Well, that's right, Jenny. I was able to get out and spend a little time with my daughter over the youth season. We had a great time. We had some friends that invited us down for a little deer camp action the night before the big youth season, so you get to check that out. We had a great time in the woods, and it was a hunt that I won't soon forget. We're also going to see some of your photos. We've been getting a lot of pictures of folks that were successful on the youth season. We're just going to take a peek at some of those this week. So we've got a great show lined up for you this week. You stay tuned. I'm Jimmy Gretzinger, and it's time for Michigan Out of Doors.
From the first spring rains to the soft summer breeze, dancing on the pine forest floor. The autumn colors catch your eyes, here come the crystal winter skies. It's Michigan, Michigan out of doors. Someday our children all will see this is their finest legacy, the wonder and the love of Michigan as the wind comes whispering through the trees. The sweet smell of nature's in the air. From the Great Lakes to the quiet stream, shining like a sportsman's dream, it's the love of Michigan we all share.
Michigan Out of Doors is presented by Greenstone Farm Credit Services, making recreational land ownership possible across Michigan and Northeast Wisconsin. Begin your land financing journey at one of Greenstone's 37 locations or visit greenstonefcs.com. By Meyer, a destination for hunting, fishing, and camping. From bug spray and tents to GPS and gas, Meyer has nearly everything you need to take on nature and get you there. Meyer. By G5 Outdoors, makers of the Quest and Prime bows. Manufactured and designed in Memphis, Michigan, G5 offers archery bows, broadheads, and accessories. On the web at g5outdoors.com. By Country Smokehouse, offering a variety of meat products, Country Smokehouse is located 3 miles south of I-69 on M53, just south of Imlay City. Country Smokehouse is a meat processor, a butcher, and a destination for sportsmen.
Instead of heading north to deer camp, my 12-year-old daughter Jamie and I headed south to the Fenville area, not far outside of Holland, Michigan. Like most lake cottages, the dock was full of kids catching fish while someone started to grill. Tim Becker was nice enough to invite Jamie and I down for the youth season. As he showed us some trail cam pics, he talked a little bit about the youth season.
I'm so happy that they changed the laws that now the youth can go out at any time as long as they're, you know, with a legal adult that holds a legal license. And I think it's a great way to get kids into the sports, get them out there. The youth season that they now have is, it's my favorite time of the year. 4 or 5 years since that early doe and youth has started, I've always taken kids out here. And I like to watch them have fun, the excitement. I've harvested enough animals, I get enough to eat, but there's nothing better than bringing somebody else out there and getting to see the excitement with them.
Well, the anticipation was running high at the campfire, to be sure. Morning was not far away, and as the sun began to rise, Jamie and I were settled in and ready to go. Now, the property we were on was about a 130-acre piece, and it does hold some very nice bucks by the picks that Tim had. We were hoping for one of those, but we had decided that the first deer that gave us a good shot inside of 100 yards, we were going to try and take it. Now, the blind we were in was pretty awesome, to say the least, and it did help that it was pretty big, because when Jamie spotted our first deer, we had to move everything in the blind to get to where she could see it and the camera could see it. And we were hoping that we would get set up before the deer moved on. So I did finally get to where I could get the deer on camera, but just barely. The deer was feeding under an old apple tree and was there for a few minutes, but by the time we got into position in the corner of the blind, the deer began to move off to our right. So we picked back up and moved to the position we had started from. Moving cameras and tripods and hunters with deer only about 40 yards away, well, it's not a quick process. But we didn't spook the young deer, and we were about ready to get back on the deer as it entered into one of our shooting lanes. Now, to be honest, I was as excited for this little yearling deer as I have been on any of my deer hunts. I was just hoping that the deer would present us a shot and that Jamie would be able to make the shot. So the deer was about ready to move into the lane. We got Jamie all set, and at about 50 yards away, the deer got out from behind the leaf cover for Jamie to settle in her 20-gauge slug gun. See the deer?
Well, we saw it over in this corner over here, and it was kind of just right there, so we moved all our stuff over there and we got all situated, and then it started walking behind a whole bunch of this tree and we couldn't see it, and then we saw it start to move back into this lane thing, so we moved all our stuff back and it was behind all the leaves and we got it in the right position and I shot it.
Oh, Jamie, congratulations. Good luck.
Oh, you're the best.
Well, you did good. You showed a lot of patience and everything. I mean, that deer kind of... Well, for those dads out there that have taken their daughter with them hunting on their first successful hunt, well, you know what I was feeling. I was about as proud as you can get. And yes, we would have loved for it to have been a big buck, but to be honest, I don't think I could have been more excited had this been a 10-point, a nice doe, or a little button buck. Hoping to take a deer out of here no matter what it was, and just wanted to have a good experience for Jamie. Want to make sure that the deer came in, kind of stopped, gave her a good shot. You drilled it right in the shoulder. What a great shot. Congratulations. That's cool. Well, that would be it for our hunt, but there were a few buddies that had some cameras with them as well. Dan Lipsky was hunting with Sam Frank and his dad, Greg Frank, in Ottawa County. This was an evening hunt, and the boys were making their way to a field edge that had been holding a nice bachelor group of bucks. Dan told me it was pretty much a for sure thing that Sam would at least get a shot. And sure enough, it looked pretty good as a nice group of deer were hitting the field. And the only problem that Sam had was just deciding which buck he liked. It looked like the lead buck was the biggest, so Sam was getting ready to drop the hammer on him. There were a lot of these walks on the youth season. Young hunter followed by older hunter, both with smiles on their faces.
Oh, that's a good shot. What do we got here? Oh, that's a mainframe six with all kinds of trash.
That's a good point.
Pretty sweet, though. Got a lot of stuff on the bases, don't we?
Yeah.
You are the king of the no-brow six.
I am.
Well, Sam and his dad, Greg, had a great hunt. And thanks to Dan Lipsky for sharing it with us. Another proud dad was Josh Steckety. His son, Ashton, was staring at a huge 9-point the opening night of the season.
You spined him, Ashton. Great shot, buddy.
And we got really neat velvet pictures of this one and one other buck. And, yeah, we're just blessed and thankful, huh, bud?
A great hunt for sure. Now, many of the kids that made it out will now be hooked on hunting, and that is really the goal of the youth season. Now, let's take a minute or so and look at a few others who were successful in Michigan's Out of Doors.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, I got to spend some time at a bear camp with brothers Rob and Wade Nixon. They're guides in the Cadillac area, and they have a great reputation for putting people on bears pretty consistently. Well, this year, when I found out that Rob was taking out one of the Pure Michigan Hunt winners, I figured I'd better head back to their camp.
In Wexford County, just outside of Cadillac, the black bear population is pretty sizable. This popular hunting area, located in the Baldwin Bear Unit, is known for producing some big bears. Rob and Wade Nixon have been guiding hunts for more than 18 years out here and have a great reputation for guiding successful hunts. This year, Rob was guiding Jim Bosher, the sheriff in nearby Maumee County, and one of the lucky recipients of this year's Pure Michigan Hunt.
Oh boy, all right, excited or what?
Very excited.
All right.
Just coming from work, and this is gonna be a lot more fun than going to work.
Awesome, so. All right. What do you think, Rob?
We're gonna try to put him on a real big bear tonight. Hopefully the weather cooperates and the bear comes in.
You got some nice ones around, eh?
There's some big ones, a couple nice ones, so hopefully it'll work out.
Cool.
Before Jim and I hit the woods, Rob showed us some of his trail cam pictures from the stand where we'd be sitting tonight. Within the last week, a couple of big bears have been hitting the bait. One was recognizable with a couple of scars on his face. Rob said if that bear came in tonight, there's no doubt Jim should take it.
That bear is gonna be a huge boar. The bear you've seen was a nice boar, real nice boar, and they don't stand baits every day. A sow will come in to bait every day almost for a month that we bait. The boars will come in generally 3 to 4 times a week if you're lucky, and they travel a lot, so they just don't stand the baits. This huge bear has been on that bait for the last 3-4 nights, so now he might have taken off, but he will come back.
Okay.
And we're just holding out for him.
Jim was excited to get in the stand. We'd be sitting on the edge of a swamp in a double ladder stand. Hunting in the rain made it a little challenging to keep his gear dry, but Jim was loving every moment of this part of his Pure Michigan Hunt experience.
Very fortunate this year. I was one of the 3 Pure Michigan Hunt winners. I only bought 2 tickets, so I'd strongly urge everyone to put the drawing in while it comes as a total shock. It's been a great experience this summer. It's a drawing that the state of Michigan has. You can pick them up at any dealer that sells licenses, or you can do it online when you pick your hunting licenses up. It costs $4 per entry. You can enter as many times as you'd like, and all the money goes to the wildlife research. I only purchased 2, one in the spring when I purchased a hunting license, and one in the fall with a deer license. And to say the least, I was very shocked when I received the call that I was one of the winners. The Pure Michigan Hunt allows you a tag for spring and fall turkey, which I've filled both of those already, a elk tag, bear tag, antlerless deer, and waterfowl in one of the managed areas downstate.
With just 15 minutes left of shooting light, the first bear of the evening made its way in. Jim was able to get a good look at this bear's face, and after much deliberation, he decided it wasn't the boar with the scarred up face that Rob showed him. Being the first day of the hunt, Jim decided to hold out for old Scarface.
Starting to get dark, and the only thing we'd seen were, I think, 1 chipmunk and several raccoons. Nothing else had been coming in, but we knew these bears were coming in late. And this bear moved in and did present a shot. We could have shot that bear that night, but elected not to. And then after that, it was too dark to shoot, and the shooting times were up. So looking forward to this. Hope to do the best that I can on this. And even if we don't get that bear, I'm sure we'll get a quality one.
An exciting hunt tonight for sure. With daylight fading to dark, we headed back to camp to see how everyone else had done tonight. And the guys at camp were pretty relentless with the ribbing.
All right, tell me what happened so far tonight.
Well, we had a pretty exciting first night. Jay seen a couple, took a shot with a pistol and
missed one.
Unfortunately missed it. Jim and you, Jenny.
Yeah, what did you see? We just showed you the footage of that bear we saw.
And I'm gonna have a chance for a rebuttal here.
Okay, but it was definitely not Scarface, so he didn't shoot.
I gotta admit it. Probably wasn't, but I didn't get a good look at the face yet. He's a dandy bear. We knew there was another big boar in there. That's probably the second big boar. So Jim did good, but I'd have been happy if he'd have shot it.
About 10 to 8, he came out, didn't stay out very long. We could have killed him. We had him in the scope, we had good light. But then he took off. We thought possibly the bigger one was coming in the way he left the bait, but nothing showed up, so we're going to get him tomorrow.
All right. So what else is going on? Where are we off to now?
108 hunter shot a bear, and he actually dropped it on the bait, so I know we're going to go in there and take a look. He says it's a huge bear, and it's
a little celebration
exciting.
Tonight.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Good deal.
Bear hunts out here seem like a community effort. Heading out into the woods, it looks like the entire town comes out to help track a downed bear and join in the celebration, which makes it that much more fun.
Congratulations. What's your name?
Ken Nash.
Ken?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Saranac.
All right. That seems we're going to have to hear the whole story here, yeah. But was it pretty exciting?
Yeah, it was.
Good
yeah.
deal. Looks like you dropped him, hey?
Yep. Oh, yeah.
What were you using?
Muzzleloader.
Cool. Yeah. Awesome. So your first Michigan bear?
Yeah.
Very cool. All right. We'll let you catch up to it.
All right.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks.
Once the guys got Ken's bear loaded up, we all headed to Wade's house, where the real celebration began. Over the years, this bear night tradition has grown into a huge event for the whole town to enjoy, which is pretty cool.
So everyone just comes out here to see the bear? Is that what's going on?
Yeah, pretty much. We just lived down around the road and heard somebody got a nice one, and we figured we'd stop by and see what was what.
Nice.
A broken tailgate.
Whoa.
Holy junk, look at that boy.
It's pretty neat to see a whole town gather together out here to help celebrate the successes of the guys who come to hunt here. The folks here really enjoy hearing the stories of the hunt and checking out the bears on the bear pole. The next day, Jim was raring to go.
Jim, using a different gun today?
Yes, I am. Just decided to switch to a different one with a little different bullet in it this time. Going to be shooting hopefully at about 60 yards tonight. Still a 50 caliber muzzle loader. This is a Thompson Center Encore.
Okay.
Jim decided to make the switch to this gun since it had a little bit better optics for low light conditions. We headed into the woods and up into the stand to settle in for the evening hunt, but there would be no settling in. Jim's a big jokester, and I was still getting adjusted in the stand when he said he saw a bear. I thought he was joking, but realized very quickly we had a bear on the bait.
There's a bear.
For real?
He's coming back.
He does look big. Yeah. Unbelievable. Nice job, man.
Took us a while to decide, but
I didn't think you even had the primer cap on yet. I didn't even have the camera on the tripod I thought you were joking me.
Yeah, I saw him come right around the corner. And he came and he ran off for just a minute and he come back and it looks like that bear from last night, a big bear, big boar.
Nice job. I can't tell with that smoke what happened.
He ran to the left. We're going to have to go down and see.
Sweet. Good job. Oh, my goodness. What time is it? 4:30?
4:35. Just walked in. We may have even put him off the bait. I'm not sure. But,
yeah. I mean, we just got and literally just sat down. Didn't even have our stuff settled yet. My backpack's still between my legs. Cool. Good job.
Let's go find him. Okay.
Jim's 50 caliber muzzleloader did the trick and produced a nice blood trail to follow. Just over the ridge from the stand, Jim walked up on his first Michigan black bear and was all smiles.
You got him, yes. Nice job. Boy, he did not go very far at all. How far do you think he went?
Maybe 100 yards.
Maybe, I don't even know if it's that far.
Congratulations. Beauty. Good job. Nice shooting.
Thanks.
Nice bear.
Not the bear we were looking at. He's a nice bear. Really nice bear. So,
looks like a boar. Got some length and good job.
Crazy
Thank
fast.
You. Thank you for everything.
Good shooting.
Jim was having a blast and enjoying every minute of his Pure Michigan bear hunt.
Probably one of the greatest things about the Pure Michigan hunt is the guides and everyone else wants you to succeed just as much as you do. You know, such as the bear hunting here, you know, they are going out of their way to make sure, you know, that we get a quality bear. I'd known Rob before, but not real well, but it's his reputation that he has for taking care of his hunters and providing, you know, quality hunts.
And a quality experience he'll never forget. The guys got the bear tagged up with Jim's Pure Michigan tag. That's something we don't get to see every day. Back at camp, Jim's wife Cindy and granddaughter Olivia were waiting to congratulate him.
So have you been supportive through this entire Pure Michigan hunting
yes.
process?
A lot of time alone.
Pretty cool deal, huh?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. He's been enjoying it. It's a great thing. So
awesome. All right. Well, hopefully we'll get his elk on camera, too. That'd be kind of fun.
Hopefully. Yeah. Maybe next weekend.
All right. Cool.
Congratulations to Jim Boscher on a great Michigan black bear. He's experiencing a whole year's worth of Pure Michigan hunting, and Rob Nixon came through to help him fill his bear tag. Good luck to all of Michigan's bear hunters out there this fall. It's an exciting time to be out in the woods here in Michigan's Out of Doors.
Thanks for joining us this week for Michigan Out of Doors. If you're ever wondering what's happening behind the scenes or off camera, you can check us out online. Head to our website at MichiganOutofDoorsTV.com or Facebook at Michigan Out of Doors TV or our new Twitter page. All sorts of exciting stuff coming up over the next few weeks, right, Jimmy?
Well, that's right. There is a ton of stuff happening right now in the great old state of Michigan. And if you're going to be joining us over the next few weeks, we've got some river fishing from both the PM and the Manistee, some muskie fishing from Lake St. Clair, some grouse and woodcock hunting from northern Michigan, a great bear hunt on next week's show. And that's not even to mention the archery season is now open. And so we're going to have stories for you kind of trickling in throughout the season. It is a wonderful time of the year to be a sportsman in this great old state. And hopefully, if we don't see you in the woods or on the water, we'll see you right back here next week on your PBS station.
Michigan Out of Doors is presented by Jay's Sporting Goods with locations in Clare and Gaylord. Jay's, serving the Michigan outdoor enthusiast since 1971 with a wide variety of outdoor products. The gear, the knowledge, the tradition of Jay's on the web at jayssportinggoods.com. By Rosie Brothers. Located in Dryden, Michigan, Rosie Brothers has been serving Michigan for over 40 years. Specializing in outdoor needs, Rosie Brothers features Kubota tractors and equipment for use in farm, home, or commercial needs. On the web at rosiebrosinc.com. By Propane, exceptional energy. Propane retailers promote the safe use of Michigan-produced gas energy in homes, farms, and businesses across our great state. Learn more at usemichiganpropane.com. by Meyer, a destination for hunting, fishing, and camping. From bug spray and tents to GPS and gas, Meyer has nearly everything you need to take on nature and get you there. Meyer. Closed captioning is brought to you by Propane, exceptional energy. Propane retailers promote the safe use of Michigan-produced gas to outdoor enthusiasts across our great state.
When I wander far away, a dream stays with me night and day. It's the road that leads to my home state. I am a Michigan man. Changing seasons paint the scene like rainbow trout in a hidden stream. The white-tailed deer in the tall pine trees. I am a Michigan man. I am a Michigan man.